When we talk about faith, we often use the language of belief. And commonly when we talk of belief, what we are meaning is ideas that we affirm. But when Jesus said to his friends and followers, "Believe in me," he was inviting them to trust him and to follow in the way of living to which he had called them. Faith is a path we choose in life. And yes, for the Christian, it's a path we choose because we believe certain things about Jesus. But we live this life he calls us to because we trust Jesus that this life leads to a flourishing life for ourselves and for the world. Welcome as we pause in this time of reflection. I greet you from Ngunnawal country and invite you to reflect on the country where you are and the first peoples of that land. Jesus calls us to follow, for the way in which he leads is the path of life. It is said that just prior to the people of Israel crossing the River Jordan and entering the land of promise, Moses gathered them to offer final words of encouragement and instruction. It was a rather long message that he delivered to them, but at the heart of it were these words. "See, I have set before you today life and prosperity, death and adversity. If you obey the commandments of the Lord your God that I am commanding you today, by loving the Lord your God, walking in his ways, and observing his commandments, decrees, and ordinances, then you shall live and become numerous, and the Lord your God will bless you in the land that you are entering to possess. I call heaven and earth to witness against you today that I have set before you life and death, blessing and curses. Choose life so that you and your descendants may live, loving the Lord your God, obeying him and holding fast to him, for that means life to you and length of days, so that you may live in the land that the Lord swore to give you to your ancestors, to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob." As I said, Moses' speech is rather long. He reminds the people of Israel of all that God has done and all that is promised. He reminds them of the blessings that lay in following the laws that they have been given and the danger of ignoring God's way. In essence, he is detailing to them what it means to be the people of God, and he is encouraging them, his listeners, to be faithful as the people of God. For this, he says, is the way of life. Jesus would have delivered his Sermon on the Mount over 1400 years after the time Moses is said to have offered his sermon. But there is a distinct similarity in purpose. For in the Sermon on the Mount, which opens with the Beatitudes and the call to be salt of the earth and the light of the world, Jesus is outlining the life of the people of God's new community of justice and peace, a people shaped by the compassionate character of God. And indeed, compassion and living well and fairly with each other sits at the heart of both messages. For this is the heart of God's calling upon us to live honoring God as we build caring and fair communities. In ancient Israel, the people that Moses was talking to, it was founded around the law, which was also so much more than just a set of rules. We often perceive it as being like a set of rules, but it is so much more than just rules intended to constrain. Rather, the law was a path to realizing Israel as a flourishing community in which all were cared for and treated fairly. Jesus challenged those who would use the idea of the law as a measure where they could say, "Well, this is enough, I've done all I need to." For the vision of God's community of justice and peace was an ideal to always be aspired to and work towards. A vision which embraced all people, all creatures, all things. a vision of all things respected, of a flourishing life which would always call us on. Moses encouraged the people of Israel to choose life. Jesus builds upon the teachings of Moses to show just how expansive and liberating and life-giving it is to choose this life. He calls all that would listen to follow, for this is the path of life. During this season of Epiphany, we have been reflecting upon the call to be light to the world. In Isaiah's Song of the Suffering Servant, the prologue to the Gospel according to John, and Jesus' Sermon on the Mount, the phrase has recurred, applied to Israel, to Jesus, and to the followers of Jesus. We are this light in our living faithfully as God's new community of peace, realizing in our life the inbreaking of God's gentle revolution, not just as an example for others to see, but as a presence influencing and shaping the world around, like salt adds taste to all the food that is mixed into. We are the light of the world. Let your light shine.
See?
Let's pray. Loving God, as we hear of struggles and troubles from afar and know many concerns in our own lives, as we hear of the earthquake in Turkey and Syria and the loss of life, injury and damage that has resulted, as we hear of the continuing conflicts in many places around the world, as we hear of the ongoing damage to our planet and of our need to live more gently and sustainably with the planet and all creatures which live here, as we hear the ongoing call for justice for Australia's Aboriginal people, that we may be reconciled and walk together as First and Second Peoples in this land, as we hear the concerns and struggles of those close to us, our hearts are moved to compassion. We mourn. We desire peace and justice in our world and mercy for all who grieve, suffer and struggle. We desire that we may all learn to live humbly with each other and all others, that all life may flourish in our world. We pray for the coming of your Commonwealth of Peace and that we may be agents of its realisation. Lead us in the paths of life, O God, that the abundant life of your realm may always be our goal. Lead us from fear to faith. Lead us from despair to hope. Lead us from greed to generosity. Lead us from indifference to compassion. Lead us from confusion to wisdom. Lead us from discord to peace. Lead us from hatred to love. Lead us from sorrow to joy. We long to be made new. Renew us in your love, O God, that we may follow Jesus as he leads us in the paths of life. Amen. Jesus, be with you. In the joy and the sorrow, in the triumph and the frustration, in the beautiful and the challenging, Jesus, be with you. In the places you fear to enter, the people you fear to meet, the situations you fear to endure, Jesus, be with you. To comfort, to inspire, to journey alongside, to strengthen and to bless, Jesus, be with you. Amen.